Hello viewers, this lecture series is of Management Accounting, which is in third semester of BCom Honours as well as BBA of Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. With the help of this lecture series, you are in a position to do all the most important concepts that every student should do who is appearing in the examination. And the recorded, all recorded lectures will be as per the syllabus designed by GGS IPU, and it is comprises of all four units. So today I will start first unit, and the topics to be covered in this lecture are the meaning, definition, aim, nature, scope, merits and limitations of management accounting. Then we will do comparison of all the branches of accounting, that is financial versus management accounting, financial versus cost accounting, and comparison between all three of them. And finally, we will cover management accounting with its role, meaning, functions, and requisites for a successful management account. Well, my dear viewers, we all know that there are three branches of accounting, that is financial accounting, cost accounting, and management accounting. When we talk about financial accounting, it is basically recording, analyzing, and summarizing all financial transactions of an entity and interpretation of results thereof. When I talk about cost accounting, it is that branch of accounting which lays emphasis on the calculation, that is ascertainment and controlling of cost of product or services which have been offered. And finally, the management accounting is that branch of accounting which is purely emphasis on the financial data provided by financial and cost accounting. And these financial data is basically used as an assistance to the management. And as a simple meaning of management accounting, it is the presentation of analysis of all business activities, especially to the internal management. Internal management, that is only the insiders, or you can say that is the persons who are doing the thinking function, or who are making policies, laid down the objectives, and how to achieve those objectives. They just pass on the instructions. And this management accounting assists the internal management to facilitate decision making at various aspects. Now, as per the Chartered Institute of Management Accountant London, management accounting is defined as the application of professional knowledge and skill in the preparation of accounting information in such a way as to assist management in the formation of policies and in the planning and control of the operations in the undertaking. So this definition clearly lay emphasis on how management accounting is basically helpful to the top level of management. That is clearly mentioned, it assists management. If management means, again I will repeat, who do only thinking function, who lay down the objectives, and they pass on the instruction that is to be done. But these instructions should be in the proper policies, and as well as it should be properly planned as well as controlled. And all the operations of an entity are in making such a way that to achieve the objectives of the entity. Now, before I start aim and nature of the management accounting, till here it is clearly mentioned that management accounting is a basically function of top level of management. As we all know, there are three levels of management. Top level, that consists of board of directors, CEOs, managing director, chairman, and all those who done thinking function. Then second one is managerial level, in which all managers are to be considered, that is sales manager, production manager, finance manager, stores manager. That is why it is termed as managerial level. And finally, third one is supervisory level or level who done all the executory functions. So top level of management gave objectives to managerial level. Managerial level pass those objectives, or they make certain policies how these objectives to be achieved, and just pass on the instruction to the lower level or supervisory level of management. With keeping this in mind, we are in a position to know what are the aims and nature of management accounting. So first aim of management accounting is formulating strategies. As I discussed, that strategies which are to be performed, which are to be made, to lay down to achieve the objectives of the entity. So the basic of main of management accounting is to formulate the strategies, lay down the objective. Then next one is planning and constructive business activities. What is to be done? How is to be done? that is basically to plan and construct the business activities at various levels of operations. Then it helps in its main aim, or helps in making decision at the right time, at the right place, what is to be required and why it is to be required. So there are various alternatives in which the decision is to be taken. Then one of the most important aims is optimal use of resources, means the resources which are being utilized in the management accounting, they are utilized in such a way that it should be effectively as well as efficiently used. All the resources should be efficient as well as effective. And that is why the scope of duplication of work or wastage of resources is as minimum as there. Then second last is supporting financial reports preparation. Management accounting also aims to support financial reports preparation, which are to be provided to the top level of management by the managerial level. Or sometimes these reports also helps as an evidence for the outsiders also. And finally, safeguarding assets. Assets means those things which are to be used for a long period of time by an entity. So management accounting also safeguard asset by keeping in mind that the few things like insurance of an asset or depreciation provision should be there. These kind of things are done in management accounting. Now, as far as nature of management accounting, it is first one, a tool for decision making. That management accounting is required to take necessary decisions. And these decisions are regarding the growth, the prosperity of the business. Then management accounting through its various tools assists the management in decision making. The next one is, it is a technique of planning and control. Means management accounting lays down some systematic plans. What is to be done, why is to be done, how is to be done, for whom to be done, and where is to be done. Not only planning, it also lays down systematic controlling procedures. Means looking backward also. And appropriate planning and controlling, they are essential for taking logical decisions and their effective implementation. And last nature is that it relates to future. That is the primary nature of management accounting, that it is totally futuristic, future oriented. That is, it focuses on the future. Now, scope of management accounting. Scope means the area which are broadly classified in management accounting, or those areas which are to be considered under management accounting. Where the first one is financial accounting. Well, financial accounting provides the basic information for analysis by management. And the historical data, records, and accounting details of all financial accounting helps the management to plan for the future. Then second one is cost accounting. Well, management accounting techniques are primary cost accounting techniques, like the techniques of marginal costing, budgetary control, and standard costing. These are the important tools of control which are in the hands of management. The concepts of controllable and uncontrollable cost, relevant and irrelevant cost, opportunity cost, differential costs, etc. They are used not only in cost accounting but also in management accounting. Forecasting and budgeting. Well, forecasts provide the basis for budgets. Predetermined targets help people in business to perform tasks accordingly. And if there are variation or any variances, corrective steps are to be taken by the management. Then management reporting. The reports which are prepared at lower level or at a managerial level, they are submitted to the top level, that is to the upper level of management. And both routine and special reports are maintained in management account. Then statistical tools. If I talk about statistical tools like graphs, charts, diagrams, tables, accounts, etc., they are used to present the accounting information to make it more meaningful and presentable. And they all are part of management accounting. Then financial analysis and interpretation. Well, analysis of financial statements and their interpretation really helps to find out the profitability, solvency, and liquidity position of an enterprise. Then control. As I discussed earlier, controlling is looking backward. So the basic objective is here is to use various resources available in the most economical, efficient, and effective manner. And this can be fulfilled when different techniques of controlling are adopted. Tax accounting. Tax has become an important part in business life nowadays. Proper tax planning and tax management saves funds for the business. Then internal audit. internal audit has become so important these days that management relies heavily on it. Why? Just for fixing responsibilities and taking action against individuals. The system used in as a basis of performance appraisal. And finally, office services means office routines. They are controlled through management accounting. Utility of the alternative office procedures and accounting system may be evaluated and reported by management accounting. So it was these all over the scopes of management accounting. Now, advantages or merits of management accounting. Utmost advantage is greater efficiency. Means management accounting increases the efficiency of not only its management, but also of its employees. Then better planning. As I said, planning is looking before you leave. And it is the first and foremost task of the management so that things can be done in an orderly way. Accounting information leads to establishment of goals and a suitable course of action for achieving these goals. Then where there is a planning, there is a controlling. So that is our third important advantage is better control. Now controlling, we all know, is a process of comparing the actual with the standard performance. And whenever there are any deviation, taking corrective action so that these deviations should be not only detected, but how to minimize these detections, these deviations, those decisions should be taken. Then coordinating. Coordinating involves interlinking of different divisions of the business enterprise in a way so as to achieve the objectives of the organization as a whole. So perfect coordination is required among production, purchase, finance, say personnel, sales, I mean different departments of the organization. And in management accounting, effective coordination is achieved through departmental budgets and reports. Then organizing, management accounting also plays a prominent role in organizing. The whole organizing is divided into suitable profit or cost center, which are very important part of responsibility center. A sound system of internal control and internal audit for each of the cost profit center helps in organizing and establishing a sound business structure. Then motivating. Periodical departmental profit and loss account, budgets, reports, these helps the superiors to find out whom to demote or promote or whom to reward or penalize. So it gives a sense of motivation among the employees. Then communicating. Communicating means transmission of data result that is among the different departments, different personnel. Then performance appraisal. Will the technique of budgetary control and standard costing help management in evaluating the performance of different departments, persons, machines, centers, etc.? And finally, wealth maximization. Well, the meaning of wealth maximization to increase the wealth of shareholders. And that is the ultimate objective of every business, just not to maximize the profit, but to maximize the wealth of shareholders. And that can be done through optimizing profits also. So this is possible through reducing cost of production, increasing scale, sales, and in all these advantages leads to the development of individual as well as organization at a glance. Then where are the advantages? There will be the limitations. So there are also few limitations of management accounting. Like first one is comparatively a new discipline. As it is said that management accounting is of a recent origin as compared to the other branches of the accounting. This is said because its principles, rules, and conventions are still in evolutionary stage, and they are being tried, shaped, and reshaped again and again. Means still a lot of research will need to be done in this area so that this field will be perfect and will be treated as a perfect tool in the area of management. Then wide applicability or wide scope. Management accounting covering so many wide areas and so many disciplinary creates problems. Non-monetary factors are also tried to be qualified and future is quite uncertain. That is why it is of wide scope. Then resistance to change or opposition to change. Management accounting demands a breakaway from traditional accounting practices. It calls for a rearrangement of the personnel and their activities, which is by and large not liked by the people involved in it. And that is why there is always a resistance to change. Then too costly. The installation of management accounting system requires heavy cost, and that is why it can be adopted only by big concerns. A small entity or a medium-sized entity is not in a position to adopt management accounting system because of heavy cost involved in it. Then a means, not an end. Management accounting is simply a mean to achieve the desired goal or introduction of the system, which does not suffice here. Then subjectivity. Management accounting is free to have its own principles, institutional judgments based on sound analysis provided by accounting information. So it is not as precise that as the financial accounting is. Input limits. The financial accounting and cost accounting information provides historical data, means they both are primarily looking backward, and they are the primary source of feedback to the management accounting. The strength and weaknesses of the management accounting depends directly on the strength and weaknesses of these basic records, which are provided by financial and cost accounting. So if there is any limitation in any of the branches, that is financial or cost accounting, it automatically reflects in the management accounting. Then management accounting is only a tool, means it cannot replace the management at all. Management accountant is only an advisor to the management. The decision regarding implementation, his advice is always to be taken by the management, and that is why it always remain as a tool, as a facilitator, cannot be an end. Then provides only data, means it provides only data, not decision. It informs, not prescribes, and that is why this limitation is always to be kept in mind by the management while using the different techniques for their organization. And personally bias. The interpretation of financial information depends upon the capacity of an interpreter, as one has to make a personal judgment, and personal prejudices and bias affects the objectivity of decision. So these are the limitations, but whatever the limitations, management accounting importance is by large such important that these limitations were overcome by the advantages of management accounting. I mean, management accounting is not only important branch of accounting, but it is also useful by the n number of enterprises for future production. Now in next set of slides, we will cover the comparison between these three branches, that is financial, management and cost accounting. First we will do financial accounting and management accounting difference. Well, if I talk about definition, financial accounting is an art of recording, classifying and summarizing all financial transactions of an entity and interpretation of results thereof. Means it records different financial transactions, then classified into ledgers and summarized into final accounts, and then interpretation through ratios and other tools. Whereas management accounting is interpretation of accounting information for the management, and that is precisely to plan the future and to make decision and control for their internal procedures. Then the level of details. Financial accounting simply shows how business moved in the past, means historically oriented, whereas management accounting shows how business has to be moved in future, that is future oriented. Management accounting is prepared for historical data. Management accounting is to be prepared for future. Then the objective of financial accounting is to provide information to insider as well as outsiders, whereas management accounting provides information only to insiders. When we talk about insider, it means only the management, employees or workers, whereas outsider also includes government, shareholders, investors, lenders, society. Then financial accounting portrays position of business as a whole. That is, what is the actual position of business in terms of profit and losses, in terms of revenues, in terms of different expenses. Whereas management accounting reports only on the performance of various division of department, profitability of sales department, profitability of finance department or purchase departments, etc. Financial accounting concentrates on past and looks backward. That is what I have told, historically oriented. Whereas management accounting concentrates on future and it is future oriented. If I talk about mandatory or compulsion, financial accounting is absolute mandatory as per the Companies Act 2013. Whereas management accounting is purely optional, and that is why it is prepared only for insiders. As and when required, it can be prepared. And if I talk about principle used in financial accounting, as it is meant for outsiders, so it has to be followed the GAAP, that is generally accepted accounting principles, which are being made in India by ICAI, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Whereas management accounting is purely for insiders, so it can adopt its own frames, its own principles, and that is why it is only a mean, not an end, one of the limitations of management accounting. Then data used in financial accounting is of past records. Whereas management accounting supplies both present and future data. Financial accounting, as in its definition, it is clearly mentioned it records only financial transactions of an entity, means those events which can be converted into money only. Whereas management accounting deals with monetary as well as non-monetary events like change in technology, change in value of money, inflation, all these things are to be also considered in management. If I talk about periodicity of reporting, financial accounting usually prepare for a year as per the accounting year concept, or sometimes half-yearly, but mandatory is to be prepared annual, that is annual basis account, financial accounts are to be prepared. Whereas management accounting, as it is prepared for insiders also, so it can be prepared at regular interval as and when required. It may be monthly, it may be weekly, or half-yearly, quarterly, yearly. Then financial accounting is precise and accurate, whereas in management accounting it is not as accurate because approximately figures are used over there. Financial accounting is more objective because it is rigid in approach, strict principles, generally accepted accounting principles to be followed, whereas management accounting is subjective as well as it means flexible in approach. In terms of performance appraisal, there is no performance appraisal in financial accounting, but management accounting performance appraisal is there. Now, next set of differences between cost and management accounting. If I talk about the definition of cost accounting, it is basically the process of accounting for cost, means it emphasizes on the ascertainment of the cost of product or services which is to be provided, as well as controlling of the cost of product and services which is provided. Whereas management accounting, again, interpretation of accounting information to guide the management for future planning for its insiders only. The scope of cost accounting is that one of its techniques is used by management accountant. So that is why it is not wider in scope or narrower in scope. Whereas management accounting uses all cost, maximum of the cost accounting tools, so it has a wider scope as compared to cost accounting. In cost accounting, there is not as rigid organizational hierarchy as in management accounting. So in management accounting, there is higher status in organizational hierarchy. The source of information for cost accounting that it uses both past and present information, whereas management accounting is lays major emphasis for future condition. In cost accounting, there is short range of planning. But in management accounting, it requires both short as well as long range of planning. Cost accounting function is purely to calculate, that is, ascertain, control, and reduction in cost. Whereas management accounting is purely concerned not only with cost, but also with the necessary information to the management for lay down objectives. Now, just have a look at the three branches of accounting. If you talk about the money cycle, financial accounting is concerned with purely money, that is economic resources, monetary terms. So cost accounting is also concerned as money as a measure for economic performance, whereas management accounting looks all situations from management point of view. Either they have to consider money cycle or something else. The scope of financial accounting, that is basic financial aspect. Cost accounting's main aim is to measure the economic performance of cost centers. What is the cost of product and how cost centers are working? Management accounting takes help from both of the branches, either it is financial or cost accounting. If we say on micro and macroeconomic factors, financial accounting consider only microeconomic factors of production center revenues. What is the cost of product and how it is what is the revenue generated, expenses bear, and profit or loss. Cost accounting analyzes cost centers different. It's related with product and processes. It is only the management accounting who takes into consideration the macroeconomic factors like change in government policy, inflation, economic environment changes, change in taste and preferences of people. So it is only management accounting which consider macroeconomic factors. If we talk about time factor, then financial accounting focus attention on past and current operation. Cost accounting focus on past and current operation, but management accounting is purely future oriented. And if we talk about technician or technologist, it is only the management accounting which are called as technologists. Why? Because financial accountant as well as cost accountant, they work like technician, means according to the direction given by them or by the superiors to subordinate. But management accountant work like a technologist, means deals with accounting information for wealth creation of its shareholders. With that, we move to the last part of the first unit, that is management accountant. Generally, we all know an accountant. Who is an accountant? An accountant is basically who helps managers to decide how to save money or how to save cost, or in basic sense, how to make profit. And that is by examining the different cost centers and to minimize the cost and to maximize the profit and how the business is making profit. So these are like management accountants. They are not only accountants, they are also risk managers who took risk, who prepare budgets, make planning. They are also called as strategists, decision makers, and they also design the format of the financial and cost control reports. So the key roles of management accountant is exactly, which is like a scope, you know, spokes in a wheel, means to drive a car, you must have spokes in a wheel which connect the rim with the hub for receiving the information. So this is what is basically a management accountant, who makes a direct connection between the management and top level of management and supervisory or low level of management. Then management accounting, it is in staff relation with other executives of its same hierarchy, maybe sales manager, maybe finance manager, maybe production manager, and in relationship with top management. Well, management accountant function like a nervous system in a human body. If it is failed, so brain dead person cannot do anything like that. If management accountant fails, so total management accounting system comes to as a collapse. Then he should possess technical and professional knowledge of high order, well equipped with financial and cost accounting statistics. He has to analyze the past critical into future, must have qualities of leadership and other managerial qualities. Now, what are the functions of a management accountant? That is planning. So this is the foremost function of a management accountant, that management accountant has to establish, coordinate, and administer as an integral part of management an adequate plan for control of the operations. It includes profit planning, say, programming for capital investment, financing, budgeting, etc. Then controlling. Well, management accountant has to compare actual performance with operating plans and standards, and to report and interpret the results of operations to all level of management, either it is a top level or middle or lower level of management. Then coordinating. Then management accountant must consult all segments of management responsible for policy of action. And as far as administrative miscellaneous function, he should administer tax policies and procedures of the governments, also supervise and coordinates the preparation of reports to various government agencies which are mandatory to be submitted. Then it ensures fiscal or financial protection for the assets like insurance of the, so that it will be used for a long period of time without any damage. Then it carries out continuous appraisal of macroeconomic factors like economic and social force of government influences and what will be the its impact on the business. Now, finally, requisites for a successful management accountant. First one is direct contact with top management. That means management accountant reports directly to the president or say CEO or say chairman of the company. Then freedom from detail, that the title of the management accountant is that of the controller. means management accountant is the principal officer in charge of accounts and performs such additional duties with the board of directors or the executive committee or the president or the chairman or the managing director of the company. And they all may assign to him from time to time. And he must have certain personal qualities. As discussed earlier, he must be a good leader, personality acceptable to all individuals, to work as a team player, ability to receive the views of the management and in a position to share those views with the subordinates as well as to the lower level of management. Then he should be understandable to how fill the role of specialist as an advisor, must be knowledgeable with theory as well as practice of management, must be, have a balanced outlook of functioning of business, and finally the capacity to think and confer with top management about matters central to profitability and progress of the company. So with this, we come to an end of the first lecture. In the forthcoming lectures, second, third, and fourth unit will be covered. Till then, thank you.